The holidays are coming.
Whether we're ready for them or not.
And when you go to the grocery store, all of the headlines on all the magazines talk about keto and carnivore and getting started, but it seems like they have conflicting information and it's very confusing.
Well, today we're going to share with you the three things that you absolutely have to do to get started on a keto or carnivore way of eating.
Hey, what's up, family? I'm Rachel.
And I'm Joe.
And we are Two Crazy Ketos.
And if you're new to our channel, welcome. Here on Two Crazy Ketos, we do different things like recipe videos, we do product reviews, we talk about various keto topics, and then every Monday, we sit down on the couch for Keto on the Couch. We just kind of talk about what's going on in our lives for the week.
You can find us in different social media platforms like Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter.
And we have a website, which is twocrazyketos.com. That's where you're going to find all of our different recipes. Now, we do upload at least 5 new videos every single week, so make sure you subscribe to our channel.
And don't forget to hit the little bell icon, and that way, every single time we upload a new video, you'll be alerted to it.
So if you go to the grocery store right now, you're going to see all kinds of front pages of magazines that say, like, keto, carnivore, how to lose 100 pounds in 3 weeks. And the bottom line is, it's very confusing.
It is. I mean, people are saying ketovore, you see the proper human diet out there. There's lots of terminologies for it. But while it is a lot of information coming at you at once, I'm also excited to see that people are starting to take a look at fueling themselves by fat instead of fueling themselves by carbohydrates.
And that's a great point, because you're going to hear a lot of different people talking terms like keto, carnivore, ketovore, the proper human diet. So let's talk about what they are. They all basically fall under the proper human diet, eating the way our ancestors ate.
Not Doritos and Pop-Tarts and things like that.
Yeah, single ingredient foods. Basically, shopping the outer aisle. Now, I know some people are gonna say, like, well, cheese isn't a single ingredient food. You know what we're talking about. We're avoiding all of the overly processed foods.
And things that were meant to live on a shelf for 25, 30, 40 years.
Yeah.
Like a Twinkie.
Yeah, so when you hear people say proper human diet, they're talking about keto. They're talking about carnivore. They're talking about ketovore. All of these different things. Atkins. So long as you're staying away from the overly processed foods, it all falls in the same thing.
Yeah.
Now, we do have an entire playlist on how to get started on keto, but we're going to, over the next couple months, completely redo that because we've changed our opinion on how to get started on keto over the last 3 years.
And we've made it simpler.
I think so. First thing we have to talk about, though, is when is a good time to get started when you're eating keto, carnivore, proper human diet, or whatever you want to call it.
Now.
What do you mean now?
The time is now. Hair past or freckle, now, right now.
Okay, but here's the problem. Like, I have a test in a week, or maybe you have a job interview in 2 weeks, or maybe, I don't know, the doctors told me that I can't lose any weight for the next month. I don't know what doctor would say that, but I'm sure somebody would.
The time is now. There is never going to be a time in your life when everything is going to be so still that you can start something new, like revolutionizing the way that you eat your food, right?
I think that's a great point, because I don't know about you, and I don't know about you guys. I cannot tell you how many times over my, let's say, I'm 50 years old, or I'll be 50 in a couple months, been dieting since I was like 15, right? I can't tell you how many times during that 35 years I said, you know what? Today is going to be the last day I eat these M&Ms. Tomorrow, I'm going to change my way. And then tomorrow comes and I'm like, yeah, I know I said today, but you know what? I'm going to start on Monday.
So don't let rationalizing get in there, right? Because we don't want to give up the junk food we've been eating. Like, if you've been a junk food junkie like us, it's very hard to say, well, I'm laying that down forever. So there's never going to be a time that I'm okay with that.
Right.
So just start now. And if this year has taught us everything, it's don't wait. Don't wait to tell the people that you love them. And don't wait to start getting healthy.
Right. Now, we said we have three different things that you absolutely have to do right now. But I'm going to give you two things that you have to do before you even get to the three things.
Okay.
Number one. Make a decision and write it out if you have to of why are you making this eating change?
Yeah, because you need to determine what your why is. You're going to have to reference that why over and over again. Maybe your why is the people that you love and being around for them. Maybe your why is feeling better and the possibility and hope that you could get off of some medications and have some better mobility. Right. But whatever that why is, you need to write it out, as Joe said, and put it all over your house so that you can remind yourself why you're doing this. And for those times when you're shaking in your resolve, you can refer back to that and it'll remind you, yeah, I still love those people and I want to do the right thing.
Okay, so number two, and I think this one is super important, and I did not do this when I started on keto 3 years ago. Don't tell anybody what your new way of eating is. No, don't tell them you're carnivore. Don't tell them you're ketovore. Don't tell them you're going keto. Don't tell your friends, your families, your loved ones, your coworkers. The only people you want to share it with is if you have like an accountability partner, like I have Rachel. And if you don't have that, go join our Facebook family group. There is a link down below and there's lots of people in there that will encourage you. But don't tell people who aren't eating this lifestyle.
It sounds weird, like we're trying to, you know, round you into a cult or something.
It sounds mean.
It does. But the truth is that you can't share your dream with everybody. If they don't understand what your motivation is, they don't get what your why is, and they are used to the standard American diet, and they think or they've heard that this way of eating is unhealthy, they're gonna discourage you. They're gonna talk you out of it. And remember, your resolve is going to waver based on all the obstacles that you have around you. And you don't want that to happen. So yeah, you don't want to kind of Lion King, I'm doing this, everybody, because then you're gonna have naysayers come into your life and it's just gonna make it that much harder to stick to it.
Now, I know you like wanna tell somebody something and you're gonna start having some results, whether it's like your arthritis goes away or, you know, you start losing a lot of weight and people are gonna ask you. Here's our suggestion. Two different things you can say. Number one, you can go with Dr. Barry's method, which is say, I'm eating the proper human diet. Because who's going to argue with, I'm eating the way I'm supposed to be eating? You don't have to go past that. The other thing you can do, very simple. I'm cutting out sugar and I'm cutting out overly processed foods. Nobody is going to argue with that.
Yeah, even your doctor is most likely going to support that decision. If they press you for more information, like they're trying to see if you are going to try to be fat fueled versus carbohydrate fueled, you can just say, look, this is my goal, is to work out sugar and work out processed foods. That's as far as I'm thinking right now. I don't think people are going to argue with you nearly as much as you are going to get argued with if you say, I'm keto, I'm carnivore, that sort of thing.
So with that being said, we've got the first three things that you absolutely have to do to get started. And there's two different ways you can do this. You can do it the fast way or the slow way. It's just how quickly do you want to get through these steps? So you ready for number one?
Yes.
Cut out all sugar. Go through your cabinet, go through your car, go through your stash that you have under the bed like I have. Get rid of all sugar. That's step number one.
And then when you are done getting rid of all sugar, go get a glossary of like all of the terminology for sugar, because there's all kinds of names like honey and
agave.
Yeah, there's so many names for sugar. Then go back to your closet and get rid of, no, seriously, all of your sugar, because there's sugar in everything. And you're trying to get rid of it. And I promise you, you want to go through this process quickly because you're going to have a detox sort of reaction to this. I mean, when I went through this process, I threw up. I was spending a lot of time in the toilet. I had the shakes. I was sweating. This has nothing to do with the keto flu. This is literally weaning yourself off of sugar. It is the sugar that does this to you.
Now, when we say there's the fast way or the slow way, we're not telling you take 2 weeks to get off of sugar. We're saying you're going cold turkey off sugar day one. The only sweeteners, and I would even advise against this, that you should be trying to have is maybe a little bit of monk fruit, liquid monk fruit, a little bit of erythritol or Swerve, a little bit of stevia or even allulose to put in your coffee. But try to stay away from all the sweet stuff because it's going to make it that much harder to get off of the sugar. But don't take 2 weeks to get off of sugar. Day one, cut off all sugar.
Rip that Band-Aid off.
Okay, so number two, and this is where we're saying you can go slow or you can go fast. you want to take it slow and not have massive, like, you know, withdrawal effects, you're going to cut out all of the grains. And we're talking about rice. We're talking about bread, pasta, all of the grains, the starches, the potatoes, all of that stuff. I highly suggest do it all at once. No grains on day one, no sugar on day one. But some people, they want to take their time. So do sugar 1 week and grains the next week.
Yeah, that might be an easier way to wean yourself off of it. Like, you can console yourself on the sugar with some potatoes or something.
Just understand that all of those grains, all of those starchy vegetables, like eating potatoes and things like that, that becomes sugar in your body. So even if you're getting rid of the refined sugar, you're still giving yourself sugar. So it becomes your choice of how to do it. But that is step number one, dump the sugar. Step number two, dump all of the grains and processed foods and things like that. So step number three.
Eat meat. Eat lots of meat, because you are replacing all of the garbage you've been eating with something. We're not asking you to, like, go hungry and eat nothing. But you got to eat some meat.
Right.
Not just some, a lot. Eat a lot of meat.
So every time you think, like, I want a Hershey's bar, eat some bacon.
Yeah.
Every time you think, like, I want a piece of chocolate cake, go eat a giant fatty hamburger, like a 1 pound hamburger. Don't worry about how many calories is in it. Don't worry about, like, am I overeating? Don't worry about the fact that it's like 35% fat. Just eat a giant hamburger. Every time you want sugar or a grain or a starch, eat meat.
Now, I would suggest buying yourself some really fancy cuts of meat too. If you're a ribeye person and normally you would not invest money in a ribeye for yourself, now's the time. You've got to console yourself that you're giving up other things. So now buy exactly the flavor and texture that you like best.
And I know what you're thinking. I can't afford that. And that's great. You don't have to. You can do this with hot dogs, with Spam, with ground beef. We eat a lot of ground beef. But think about this. Take all of your sugar money.
Yes.
When you were going and buying Starbucks, when you were going to the gas station and buying a Kit Kat bar for $2, take all of that money and instead of spending it there, spend it on meat. And the next thing you know, you're going to be eating like $20 grass-fed, grass-finished steaks that, like, you know, were laid out and walked upon by somebody's feet.
Yeah, because you don't realize how much money you have been spending on junk food $1 at a time. If you go through the McDonald's drive-thru, however many times you go through that in a week, $1, $2, $3, $5, it may seem like in each session it's not that much money, but it adds up.
Right.
And you're gonna have all that budget for delicious meat.
So those are gonna be the first steps that you need to get started on this way of eating, the low carbohydrate diet.
Or whatever you wanna call it.
Yeah, whether you wanna call it ketovore, carnivore, proper human diet, Atkins, the bottom line is this: you're eating whole foods that are minimally processed. Now, on our next video, we're gonna actually talk about things like macros, like how much protein should you eat? How much fat should you eat? Should you intermittent fast? And most importantly, how much food should you eat? So make sure you're subscribed to our channel. Also, make sure you hit that little bell button so that you are notified when that next video comes out. Now, of everything we said today, there's one thing we really want to get through to you guys.
Start now.
Start right now.
Do not wait. You've got your homework. You're gonna get rid of the sugar. You're gonna get rid of the grains. You're gonna get eating meat. And then we'll go to the next step.
Yeah, we kind of need to even change that a little bit. So you're gonna do step number one, throw out sugar and eat meat at the same time.
There you go.
Step number two, you've thrown out the sugar, now throw out the grains and eat meat. But start right now. Like, as soon as this video is over, hit the stop button, run to your kitchen, throw out all the sugar. Hey, nobody in your family needs the sugar, so throw it out.
No.
Throw it all out, start eating meat today, and then you can either do step number two today, or you can do it next week, and then by the time you've gotten used to not eating sugar, not eating grains, and eating meat, you'll be ready for part two of this series.
And it will be a delicious waiting process.
Now, if you like seeing videos like this, check out some of the other videos in our playlist that we're gonna link right down there. Also, make sure you take a look at our most recent video, which you're gonna find right over there.
But whether you head this way or you head this way, don't forget to head this way. Subscribe to our channel, hit the little bell icon, and that way every single time we upload a new video, you'll be alerted to it.
Until next time.
Bye. Bye.